has it? Yours.
In 2008, but it was already running in 2007 at the end of September of that year. So we now are in a breakdown crisis of the entire international system, that is the transatlantic system. And there is no cure for this in the ordinary way. This thing is going dead on the water. And you can't say exactly what date because a lot of things can be done to adjust things in the short term. But essentially, we've reached the limit. This thing is coming down. Now, the solutions are fairly obvious. We have to go to Glass-Steagall first. But I think we have to get Obama out first. Now, I don't think that this situation is impossible now.
Don't play with what we did here today and make mockery of sincere exhortation of our president.
We got it.
That's all I'm saying, and I'm also warning to keep your hands off of me. And to the government of the United States, do your best to protect him. You slipped up and let people walk in to a dinner that they had no business being in. Your security is not what it should be. So tighten it up!
And the church said...
Ambitions as a rider like landmines. Lyrics turn niggas into smithereens. Music so lethal, turn coliseums to murder scenes. I'm Machiavelli the Don, that's what they tell me I'm on. I'm dropping niggas like bombs, getting that ass like a thong. Picture a felon in your presence, taking busters back to the essence. Telling my people, beat my lethal message. Visions of me getting money got me in mash mode. Murderous motives for niggas stopping my cash flow. You can't fight it, nigga, let go. Witness the sound, major bitch ass bail down the death row. Mama, these niggas got me fighting these three strikes. Showing up in court, fuck what you thought, it's street nights. I put the game down first, put my niggas up on it. Now we American.
Remember tilting the camera back and forth between the people and the tower in front of me.
If this building really collapsed instead of having anything else happen to it, it would have collapsed in a unique way because of the very materials which were created to form it, that when they were subjected to overpressures, they exploded as opposed to collapsing.
Yeah, but okay. Well, so
but,
I...
But, how does that explain the steel columns turning into dust? And Judy has video, obviously recorded from one of the networks or one of the stations that was shooting that day in New York, showing in a time-lapse sequence these center steel columns, after the floors have all gone away and they're just standing there naked to the sky, these three stabbing steel columns with the support structure around the center ones, they literally wistfully turn to dust and blow away in the wind.
And look how quickly they took away the crime scene.
Well, yeah, I mean, there was no stuff to take away because 90% of the building was, as Judy says, dustified. When you go through with her step-by-step what happened and the fact that there's no known science that can explain it, not even this weird concrete that when you break it, it explodes or it ejects shrapnel as opposed to just snapping. Because the steel turned into nano dust, and that can't happen in any physics that we think we know, but it's exactly what this secret black ops physics that both the Russians and our side have been playing with for decades can do, which is a totally exotic, unknown technology was used to turn those buildings into dust, to disintegrate them, like the old 1950s sci-fi flicks. It was some kind of massive disintegrator beam, almost a chain reaction of hyperdimensional energy released like a mini nuclear weapon, except it wasn't nuclear.
Well, it sounds like Tesla technology.
It's absolutely Tesla. Remember when Tesla bragged in the 20s, and of course at that time nobody was listening? He was basically, condemned to only talk to the New York Times and the New York Post and reporters who would sit around having drinks and listen to the old man, spin these tall tales. He talked about, with his physics, his technology, a disintegrator beam.
Curious George came up was because at the time that Tesla was doing his work, his grand secretary's name was George Scherf, Sr. George Scherf was the personal secretary of Nikola Tesla. Nikola Tesla's son used to go into his laboratories and ruffle around in them. One day, Nikola caught him in his laboratory going through his notes, stealing materials. And Nikola hated this little son of a bitch. Hated him. In fact, when he grew up, George Bush tried to kill Tesla by running him down. That's why Tesla got that lip. He lived. George took a car and tried to kill him. George W. Bush was stealing materials for the Third Reich as a 14, 15-year-old. He was a master spy at 14. And Nikola caught him and used to call him a little monkey. Now, the story is that on Tesla's deathbed in his hotel, he was visited one last time in April of, 1976. When did Tesla die? April. I don't remember the exact date. But during the 4 days that Tesla was interned in his bed and looking like this because he was brought out to meet the prince, he was visited one more time by this man, George Scherf. But before he was visited by George Scherf, he said, or it was said, that he was visited by two U.S. government agents. Now, we found out later on that those two U.S. government agents were actually Reinhard Gehlen and Otto Skorzeny. Otto Skorzeny confessed to the author that after he got the materials, they strangulated and suffocated and murdered Nikola Tesla. They took his materials to the American government, which is not the American government. And right now, at this moment, the Nazis have some of Tesla's most sophisticated material of all time. They have time warp machines. They have death rays. They have mind control machines. They have an arsenal that you would not believe based on Tesla's information. And Tesla was a good man. In fact, he was a great man. He was about to give electricity to everyone.
Mr. Tesla has built unusual machines for unusual people, but he would never talk about it.
I understand discretion. I just want the machine.
Finish your drink. I want to show you something. I think you'll have a special appreciation for our work.
I thought it was a secret.
You're a magician. Who's going to believe you?
Not long now. Our equipment requires a great deal of current. Tesla electrified the whole town in exchange for using the generators when we need them. We do our tests when the townspeople are asleep. Mr. Tesla doesn't want to scare anyone.
The wires.
Exactly.
Well, where's the generator?
You saw it last week.
Well, that must be 10 miles from here.
15. And I have to ride all of them before I get to bed.
I'll send word for you in a few days, Mr. Angier.
Magic. Real magic.
God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with its swelling. There is a river whose stream shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her just at the break of dawn. The nations raged, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come behold the works of the Lord, who has made desolations in the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and cuts the spear in two. He burns the chariot in fire. Be still and know that I am God.
Now, Harry Belafonte said a few weeks before Martin Luther King was assassinated, they were meeting to talk about the march in Memphis. He went over to his brother, and according to his words, he said, "Martin, you seem melancholy. What's troubling you?" And Dr. King said, "I fear that I am integrating my people into a burning house."